morning and welcome. Fathers still basking in the euphoria of Father's Day celebration as Vice President Yemi Osinbajo admonishes them on healthy society. Just as the need for exemplary life and sacrifice tops Muslim media Ramadan lecture. Plus, National Blood Transfusion Service takes campaign to schools. This and more on today's edition of Panorama. I am Lydia Bassi. Thanks for joining us. Fathers worldwide observed Father's Day, a day set aside to honor fathers. Vice President Yemi Osinbajo on the occasion admonished fathers to continue to work towards having a better society, describing them as roots of the family tree. SETA's correspondent Jide Onifade reports that the Vice President's message was delivered by Speaker Yakubu Dogara at the Aso Villa Chapel, Abuja.
A beautiful piece of artwork of a palm wine tapper working hard to provide food and other amenities for his family. A gift to all fathers all over the world through President Muhammadu Buhari and Vice President Yemi Osinbajo for the hard work and commitment in ensuring that every family in Nigeria has better life. And a sculpture formed in the image of a woman, another gift presented to Senate President Bukola Saraki for all mothers who are recognized as holding the pillar of the family. Communication among family members is of great importance to having a united and good society. And so, the gift presented to Speaker Yakubu Dogara was a carved drama, which symbolizes the promotion of healthy dialogue among family members and other members of the society. Speaker Yakubu Dogara stressed the need to honor fathers as their role is critical in building a healthy nation.
Pray for fathers, honor them. The president is the father of Nigeria. Vice President, all the other leaders, if we honor them, this country will do well.
This was corroborated by chaplain of the Villa Chapel, Sheyi Malomo.
When a family unit in a nation is strong, the nation will be strong. And I see Nigeria becoming very strong again because we are going to the foundation.
So I advise that mothers should support fathers in all aspects.
From the Aso Villa Chapel, Jide Onifade, NTA News.
Meanwhile, the occupants of the IDP camp in Durumi, Abuja, were not left out in the celebration of this year's Father's Day, as the Men's Fellowship of Rema Chapel International Churches Abuja joined them in solidarity. Adebola Brooklyn Sunday has details.
At the NTA Resurrection Chapel, the chaplain, Reverend Nelson Akinwande, who preached on the theme, The Spirit-Directed Life and Home, Where the Father is Leader, enjoined fathers to take biblical role responsibly to engender peaceful and progressive society.
We set aside a day like this that we can talk to the fathers to tell them their responsibilities to the families. And we know that when they train their families well, there will be a ripple effect of it in our society.
As others gathered on their various churches to mark the day, Men's Fellowship of Rema International Churches Abuja took the celebration to those that were displaced by the activities of the Boko Haram, most of whom lost their fathers. The Durumi camp came alive at the presence of these humanitarian fathers who donated clothing, food items, and other commodities to the occupants.
As a church, it's a joy to see other people and that are in need, and you are a blessing to them. You give them what they need.
We should be followers of Christ. What he did, so we are doing now.
We have 11 groups in this camp, Area 1. We are going to divide it into 11 groups. Any group has its own leader.
However, the secretary of the camp, Bala Yusuf, did not miss the opportunity to draw government's attention to the accommodation challenge.
Facts. In the night when rain is falling, we cannot sleep inside, and we have children inside the camp. So.
With over 2,000 internally displaced persons residing in this camp, the Men's Fellowship of Rema's Chapel International Churches Abuja is calling on other well-spirited Nigerians to come to the aid of these people. Adebola Brooklyn Sunday, NTA News.
And now to other matters. Nigerians, irrespective of ethnic or religious backgrounds, have been enjoined to practice their faith with uprightness so as to promote peaceful coexistence in the country. Catholic Archbishop of Abuja Diocese John Cardinal Nayekon gave the admonition at St. Ignatius of Antioch Catholic Church, Karu, Abuja. Olajide Bello brings us details of this and other church activities within Abuja metropolis.
It was a moment of appreciation, praises and thanksgiving as parishioners and invited guests rolled out the drums to mark 1 year anniversary of St. Ignatius of Antioch Catholic Church, Karu, Abuja. Catholic Archbishop of Abuja, Cardinal John Onaika, called for more dedication and uprightness by Christians in their service to God.
Let our spirit be enthusiastic to live according to the spirit of the Lord Jesus.
It's necessary that as fathers we represent God on earth, we represent Christ for the children.
Reverend Father Jude Oga also gave some words of encouragement for the parishioners.
We find him providing, being available, sustaining and keeping us alive.
And my prayer is that the parish will continue to grow from strength to strength.
At the St. James Anglican Church at Sokoro, fathers were celebrated and reminded of their duties and responsibilities.
And we pray that God will continue to help us.
Fathers are accounting officers of your house.
Special prayers were offered for fathers and for continued peace and stability in the country. In a similar development at the Gospel Light Redemption Church, fathers were charged to be focused and wait on the Lord for his direction. The service featured ministration of soul-lifting songs in Abuja, Olajide Bello, NTA News.
The Emir of Zazzau Soleja, Malam Mohamud Awal Ibrahim, has appealed to members of Muslim media practitioners of Nigeria to apply their understanding of the teachings of Islam in the discharge of their duties to bring about fairness and justice to all. He was speaking at the 10th Ramadan lecture organized by the Muslim media practitioners with the theme, Peace as a Catalyst for Development, the Media Challenge. Abdullahi Soleja has details.
The media is adjudged to be a strong instrument that can make Ummah a society. The Emir said, shouldering the responsibility to inform the public, it behoves on the practitioners as required by Islam to say the truth and nothing but it and verify information before publication.
Through our Quran and tradition, we have lessons to learn to regulate our practice in this kind of... And unless people are well conversant, well enlightened as to what those lessons are, we'll continue to fall in the traps of the Western media.
We need to practice more investigative journalism.
Speakers at the lecture all agreed that practitioners must avoid sensational, provocative and destructive reporting.
Justice is the soul of peace. Once you deny people justice and you deprive them of their rights, there will be crisis, there will be threats to peace and security.
In order to promote peace effectively, the media must maintain a mature and neutral level of professionalism.
Chief Press Secretary to the Niger State Government, Jibril Ndache, who represented the governor, said social media users should also note the enormity of unsubstantiated information they pass around. In Abuja, Abdullahi Musa Soleja, NTA News.
And now to matters concerning infrastructure. Following federal government's resolve to complete critical ongoing infrastructure projects, some disengaged road construction workers have now returned to work. This was part of the findings during an inspection visit by the Minister of Power, Works and Housing, Babatunde Fashola, to the ongoing construction of the Loko Oweto Bridge project linking Nasarawa and Benue State. Works correspondent Ismail Musa has details.
To ensure effective utilization of its scarce resources, the ministry earlier identified some critical projects for immediate attention. The Loko Oweto Bridge contract that would provide a shorter alternative route linking Benue and Nasarawa states is one of such projects.
And we're happy that the bridge is going this way. If you are coming from the northern part of Nigeria, you can reach to Port Harcourt easier.
While at the project site, which is currently at 57% completion, to appraise the speed, quality and level of work, the Minister of Power, Works and Housing said the present administration will accord due attention to massive infrastructure development across the country.
focusing on completion of ongoing projects. This is one of the many ongoing projects. Lagos-Ibadan Expressway was one of them. Kano-Maiduguri is one of them. Ilorin-Jeba is one of them. Second Niger Bridge is one of them. All those projects now, the contractors are moving back to site and work is beginning.
The contractor handling the project, who has fully remobilized to site, has also re-engaged over 300 workers.
This project was originally awarded in 2011 and was billed for completion in 2015. But due to issue of poor funding, the project has now been rescheduled for completion in 2018. From the ongoing local Wetto Bridge project in Nasarawa State, Ismail Musa, NTA News.
And from Benin, the chairman, Edo State Economic Team, Mr. Godwin Obaseki, is to fly the All Progressives Congress APC flag in September 10th governorship election, having emerged winner in the party's primary held in Benin, Edo State capital. Sele Osayande reports that Mr. Obaseki polled 1,618 votes to beat 11 other aspirants.
12 aspirants battled for the party's ticket, and the process to picking the party's candidate commenced with accreditation of about 2,873 delegates from 192 wards. The accreditation, which was decentralized, was done in three centers in Benin and conducted according to senatorial districts. The voting, which was done at Samuel Ogbemudia Stadium, saw delegates voting according to their local government areas, with voting over, collation and announcement of results followed. The seven-man election committee, headed by Governor of Katsina State, Aminu Bello Masari, announced Godwin Obaseki as the winner and advised him to be magnanimous in victory, just as he urged other aspirants to accept defeat.
Obaseki Godwin Noge Gasi, Mr. 1,618 votes. I call on you to extend a hand of fellowship to your fellow contestants. And for the contestant, take solace in God that he decides and chooses who represents or who leads us at any one particular time.
Humbled by the nomination, and I would like to state that this is our collective victory. I assure you that all your sacrifices and trust will usher in a more prosperous and progressive Edo State.
The guy is sound. He's at home with the issues. He's not a stranger to governance. I've worked with him for 7.5 years.
There were heavy presence of security operatives to ensure a smooth and credible process. In Benin, Sele Osayande.
In a move to deliver quality services to Nigerians, the Public Complaints Commission has launched an e-complaint integrated management system where citizens can lodge their complaints online or by dialing a toll-free number. The Chief Commissioner of the Commission, Emmanuel Ogbile, made this known at a media briefing in Abuja. Ali Tucker has the details.
Established in 1975 with the mandate of investigating complaints,
as Panorama continues after this timeout. Don't go away.
The struggle for independence had been a long and tough one. Our founding fathers and compatriots sacrificed their comfort and even shed their blood. We cannot at this point in history afford to spirit away their sacrifices for immediate but temporary gains of today. Let us emphasize what unites and not what divides us. Working for the unity of purpose, with a stronger vision for a better tomorrow. NTA, growing with the nation.
Together, no matter where you come from, no matter your religion, we are one. Let's live together.
Let's stop fighting each other. Let us live as one. It doesn't matter where you come from, your tribe or religion. Child, it doesn't matter who you are, put Nigeria first.
No matter where you come from, no matter your religion, we are one, let's live together.
How can we develop when we're always in crisis?
families have become refugees in their country, no matter our difference.
School. It gave the present students the opportunity to relate with the alumni of the school and to profess some solutions to some challenges the country is facing. With the theme Nigeria's future has been mortgaged by our civil war leaders, the students were of the view that a lot of wrong steps have been taken by the post-civil war leaders, which consequences the country is bearing today.
In the 70s, there were jobs, there were accommodation, but no more cars. In the 80s, there were jobs, no accommodation, no car. In the 70s, job was scarce. Car was a white elephant. Accommodation, don't dream of it. Now in the 2000s, what do we have?
But nation building is not an event. It's a process. So every building block has been deliberately put in place to ensure that you people will not have to suffer what we suffered.
The organizers of the event said the debate was to encourage the young generation of Nigerians to voice out their opinions and not be relegated to the background.
It's concerned about the situation in Nigeria. Before now, there have been systemic breakdown in many of the sectors. The new government is trying to fix things.
Students of Igbobi College emerged victorious in the debate. In Abuja, Oyeyemi Ajayi, NTA News.
President Muhammadu Buhari is reassuring Nigerian youths of his determination to make huge investment in them. This was in a message delivered at the swearing-in ceremony of Batch A Stream 2 deployed to Yobe State, who are undergoing their orientation course in Dutse, Jigawa State. Aminu Umar reports.
In a message delivered on behalf of President Muhammadu Buhari, Yobe State Commissioner of Youth, Sports, Social and Community Development, Alhaji Tijani Zanna Zakaria says, federal government places high premium on youth and core members. He enjoins them to be patriotic and shun all forms of social vices.
On the part of this administration, we are determined to make huge investment in youth. Government is aware of the numerous challenges confronting the NYSC, such as corps rejection, infrastructural deficit at the orientation camps, dwindling resource allocation, and so on.
NYSC Yobe State Coordinator Alhaji Abubakar Muhammad says the orientation course was designed to mold the core members for the task of nation building, hence the need for them to participate in all the programs.
The camp is an avenue for you to meet your contemporaries from other regional, cultural, religious, social or economic background. It is equally an opportunity for you to have first-hand information about other Nigerians and to show negative perception you have to have of them.
A total of 1,772 core members were deployed to Yobe State. From Dutse, Amin Umar, NTA News.
Meanwhile, President Muhammadu Buhari has returned to Abuja to formally resume duty after his vacation in London. State House correspondent Adamu Sambo reports that the president says he's okay.
It was a massive show of support, loyalty and goodwill at the Nnamdi Azikiwe International Airport as President Muhammadu Buhari alighted his aircraft at about 5:45 Sunday evening. On hand to give a befitting reception to the president include some state governors, dozens of ministers, the national security advisor, and the service chiefs led by the chief of defense staff, General Abayomi Olorun Sakin. Also at the airport were the national chairman and other executive members of the governing All Progressives Congress, members of the National Assembly, presidential aides, and other top government officials. In line with military tradition, a detachment of the Presidential Guards Brigade mounted a ceremonial guard to formally welcome and reaffirm its loyalty to the President and Commander-in-Chief. For journalists who turn up at the airport in their numbers, interviewing the President on arrival was not an easy task.
Well, you have seen me. I hope you saw me when I was going. Use your sense of judgment.
The interview session with President Muhammadu Buhari was very rowdy, but as he puts it, I am okay. You have seen me inspecting the guard of honor. Do you want to wrestle with me?
You know, I am taller than you.
The special advisor to the president on media and publicity, Femi Adesina, said President Muhammadu Buhari had a well-deserved rest and is now refreshed for the task of governance, especially the implementation of the change agenda.
We said it before he left, that he was going on holiday. Some people called it a medical leave. No, it was not. It was a leave to rest. And during that rest, experts now looked at his health. But then I also used this opportunity to thank Nigerians who wished the president well and who asked for information about his state of health. And then those who went into overdrive, who went into some sort of hysteria, I also want to appeal to them to have a positive mindset. They don't need to look at the worst case scenario when they hear about the health status of anybody, not even just the president.
We thank Almighty God for bringing our president back to his job. He's come back to his country, he's come back to his people, and business will continue as usual, as you can also you two witnessed.
How do you see him?
How do you see him too? I see him excellent.
President Muhammadu Buhari, who left Abuja for London on the 6th of this month, is to fully resume duty on Monday the 20th. From the State House, Adamu Sambu, NTA News.
Next is sports, and Adeola Omokivie has that.
Representative in the CAF Champions League, Enyimba of Aba, on Sunday failed to capitalize on home support in getting maximum points from visiting Zamalek Football Club of Egypt in the group stage of the competition. The waterlogged pitch at the Adoki Amesimaka Stadium in Port Harcourt did not, however, allow for a free flow of the ball. Zamalek Football Club held on to their one-goal lead until the end of regulation time. The People's Elephants will, on the 29th of this month, now face Mamelodi Sundowns in South Africa. The Masters Cup Secondary School Football Championship, the fifth in its series, has ended at the Onikan Stadium in Lagos. The championship, which lasted 6 months, had 30 Lagos first-generation schools competing. In the boys' finals, debutants Green Springs School beat defending champions St. Gregory's College 3-1, while the girls' final had three-time champions Queen's College thrash Federal Science and Technical College 4-0 to retain their title. According to the Nigerian Football Federation, the competition is key to identifying and grooming future national under-17 players.
In this country, the talents are in abundance. Harnessing them is what the federation is doing. In the near future, you know, towards the middle of next month, when we have the FIFA president visiting, he's going to be guest to our under-13 and under-15 tournament.
And to the roller sports, the first national delegates conference for the Roller Sports Federation held Saturday at the National Stadium in Lagos. Executive members from Rivers, Bauchi, Plateau, Imo, Lagos State, and the Federal Capital Territory took part in the forum to chart the way forward for the development of the sports in the country. President of the Federation, Joseph Eva, speaks.
Children that are 4 years, 5 years, their own